Yeah, automatically. I mean, there's the domino effect that you're looking for. Vertical slightly off, you're already in the back of the heel. Back of the heel, you're using muscle. Muscle, there's no way you could drill to a center because you're already using muscle and you won't know the path.
Good thing you're recording.
Gonna label this video Wing Chun blah blah useless talk. I bet you no one watches this. Actually, this video probably said probably the most out of all the videos combined.
Yeah. So you had, I mean, aside from the vertical, aside from the hand, the triangle being at its zero point, being supported by the body, you won't drill if that's not there. I mean, you can't drill if
You
you're not.
can't. You'll have to. You'll end up pushing. You'll end up automatically pushing. You push, you're in trouble. You push, that's why you feel the force kick back. For example, you bounce out, right? Push to me. You feel a kick back. Drill to me. Control your technique. Drill. Go down to the path. You control, you're leaning forward.
Yeah.
You gotta control yourself to drill. Hold yourself first. The elbow push down the path. Feel your vertical, control that. Yeah, see? Now push. Push, you feel it automatically kick back to you.
Can I try that again? So, correct, like trying to do a correct, can I, let me see if I can get it correctly.
Yeah, that's it.
This is what I want the heavy roll to feel like. This is what the heavy roll should feel like this amount of
Yeah, if you
drill.
want more, first I have body. If I want the heavy roll, right, I'm here. Right? I want heavy body. Now leg.
And that's what you're talking about before too with.
Yeah.
So how are you using that then? Because
I
you were
just showed
saying
you how
before,
I use it.
huh?
I just did it right there.
But you were saying before about force coming in development-wise, you have that grace period, right?
Yeah.
So arm, belly or body
Yeah.
to the legs.
Yeah.
But you were doing like, and then I asked you, well then in actual application you're kind of going reverse order, right? How are you doing that? I could feel it,
Yeah.
but when you're holding your vertical, you already want that support to already be there in the
Yeah,
legs,
automatically.
in the
Yeah.
belly,
Yeah.
right? You're not waiting for some sort of force
No.
to come in on you in order to like activate it.
No, 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 no.
It's already there,
Yeah.
right?
It's my active within
Because
the
you, I
passive.
remember you asked, we were texting one time, it was like a couple of weeks ago, I think, and you were asking me about when I'm in my stance, where do I feel it in my stance? Do I feel it in my legs? And I was saying I wasn't because I think I was still too much emphasizing, you know, right here, the belly, the body still. And so, you know, to at least get that vertical of the spine. But after a while, I didn't, you know, I could still, even though I felt like maybe physically I was in place, not everything was completely relaxed where I was feeling everything come down to the feet,
Yeah,
right?
the tension in the body.
Still too much tension
Yeah, you
here.
have to let that go.
And so I guess after that conversation, what I felt when I started thinking about it some more, I felt like I knew that I was feeling that tension right here. And so I would adjust here, like pull up a little bit, but then I
No.
could feel it
You
go
have to
down.
relax. You have to relax this in order for it to go naturally to the flow there.
Well, I don't know if maybe if this is right then, but I mean, I felt like pulling up a little bit
Well, you
allowed
have to
this to
be, yeah, because
relax.
that's the vertical.
And
Because if you
then,
don't do it, you don't have the vertical. It doesn't automatically happen.
so.
The breakdown process is this. You're looking like this. I exaggerate for you. From here, you feel my body. See my body. My body's pushing towards you, right? And then automatically now my leg pushes towards you, right? But that process, I don't even think. You just actually just do it. It just naturally happens because of how my alignment is in place. I don't go one and then two. I'm just showing you the breakdown of that. Mm-hmm. See? Breakdown automatically.
But how do I know? How do you know? How are you emphasizing it? I guess.
How am I?
Because I know. In
I already actual, I know how to hold the vertical. And then I can shoot out the power automatically. See?
It's like so easy.
It is, because all I'm doing is I'm just straight. It's just as, I'm just holding it straight. I recognize it. If I don't recognize it, I'm like this. See, I can't do it. But I recognize right away if I'm vertical or not. That's why I can do it on the instant fly.
But when you go into heavy roll, though,
yeah,
you're saying that you're using the whole body, yeah, right? Body and legs.
You're always using the whole body.
Okay.
You're always using the whole body.
But there's still a principle of like conservation with that, right?
Sure, sure. The heavy roll is just a development as far as you learning how to control the power. Because sometimes you need to go heavy. Sometimes you need to go light. That's the balance. And then you have your regular roll. 0 point and then the positive and negative of each
one. Why would you need to go between?
Because I can control it. Because, yeah, let's say it calls for it. I go from here, right? I go boom, pock. Uh-huh. Like I go boom, boom, pock. I want to kill the frick out of you. Yeah. Sometimes I might have to do that. That's the benefit of being at the 0 point. I can go positive, sometimes I have to go positive, sometimes I have to go negative. That's why I can choose. I have the ability to do that.
Okay, so it's like going all over the place.
That's natural.
But you're talking about, that's the benefit of being at the 0 point is being able to go
maximum positive, adjustment.
Negative. Does that also have something to do with the one over and one under?
Yeah, that does, but that's another subject too.
Okay. I just want to put that on tape so that I remember next time, because I'm going to forget this.
Okay.
But, okay. So then going back to the heavy roll then, or with the body. You're never going to actively or consciously use more body or use more legs, are you?
You're not. It's just natural. Because feel,
even, but yeah, depending on
it's just natural. When I stand here, I'm not thinking here and then here. I just control my vertical, and then from here, I just adjust it. I just adjust to the 0 point. I control it, and you don't even feel me doing anything. It looks like I'm doing nothing.
And right now, I'm adjusting to you, right?
Yeah,
I'm
you're just
trying to adjust, but yeah. I'm not feeling anything.
Yeah, you won't.
I have to already know.
Yeah, you're trying to adjust to me. You see, if you adjust to me, you won't be. If I give you incoming force, you won't know how to adjust. But if you think of yourself, feel what you're doing, and it just, yeah, control it.
I lost it.
Yeah, you're just aware of what you're doing. Yeah, that's better. See, right away, that's better. That's better than what you've done before. You're always late. You're adjusting after what I'm doing. You understand what we're doing?
Kinda.
That's no. I've done this too hard to know. All right. The force comes in, okay? You try to you try to deal with it. Can't, right? Feel your stance. Feel your hand technique. Make sure you support it, okay? Feel how it is. Imagine that's zero and zero, okay? Now, the force comes in. Try to adjust yourself so you feel the zero. What you have to do is adjust it. Your stance, make sure you're holding it. Mm-hmm. Feel it pull, adjust. Yeah. Yeah, a little bit better. At this level, that's pretty good. Yeah, and then I let go automatically. You maintain your zero automatically. See, it doesn't bounce forward. But he tries to adjust my force. You try to control my force. He can't. He won't.
Okay, so funny.
I know
how it just it's
so my brain. It so confuses my brain.
But then
it's so counterintuitive.
Yeah. Well. Yeah. It is. But then the you know it's a very thin line between. Both.
Yeah, it is, because one looks almost the same as the other. Yeah, if you look on this video, you won't they look, what the hell are they doing? They're not doing anything.
You have to feel it. It feels totally different.
So then how is, with those things in place, right? Mm. Or knowing those things and maybe even being able to do them at a low level, like, what is the application? How are you doing things differently between light roll and heavy roll?
Light roll, I barely touch.
But you're still.
But light roll, I want to be like a feather. The feather between us, I control it. And then when we move, I want to control it. See, I'm controlling it for myself. If I'm not controlling myself, you feel me. See, I'm basically falling. I'm not falling on you, but you feel heavier here. Mm-hmm. But if I control for myself, I feel control. See, that's the beginning. You control for yourself, the control aspect of it. Then you combine what? The heavy. You control it for yourself with the heavy and push.
I'm not pushing though or drilling. I'm just holding.
Yeah, right? you held it right for yourself. See, you're actually kicking back into me. That was automatic.
Because I was holding it for myself.
Yeah. You know your path. The path will automatically connect.
So light roll, you're doing it to hold it for yourself.
Yeah, you learned that.
But heavy roll, you're doing it
for power.
And the power comes from the drill.
Power comes from the drill and the body, but having to know how to hold it for yourself too.
If you guys are rolling light and he goes heavy,
yeah.
Will it pretty much automatically become heavy, or can you keep it light?
I can keep it light. Well, I don't do anything. I just automatically react.
Okay.
And because if I'm light like this, right, and then he put the I'm light, and then he goes heavy.
You can keep it feeling light.
No, he feels it heavy now too. Okay. My body actually. But if we go light, I don't have control of it. Let's say I lean back a little, and then he goes heavy. Oh, that sucks being like that. See, my reaction, I don't plan that. That's why. Whether I go light or heavy, he can change it. It doesn't matter. See, I automatically control it. But if I have to think, I gotta go heavy, I gotta go light at this point. No way.
So both, you're still controlling yourself, but one is with more power. Is it like heavy is just controlling yourself with, but also controlling the power?
You're just saying heavy has a little more emphasis as far as the drilling motion. All right, light, I just control it. Make sure I control the vertical and also the hand.
But there's a, what are you emphasizing in the heavy role?
I should.
I'm not going like this. Because you said to me before when we started doing it, I was bouncing a lot.
Yeah, you're going up and down like this. But look, if I go like this, you can see my body. I'm exaggerating it. I won't do it that much. But from here, boom. From here, drill there. My body, leg. Let's try again. To do heavy, you gotta practice it because it's a suck stage. Now try to do it light. Light, barely touch. You're barely touching and you want to make sure you keep the equalized neutralized at the same. Barely touch. Control for yourself.
No, I was still way active with the hands.
Yeah.
I could tell it's gonna get tired.
Yeah.
Well, how was your stance?
Sucked. I don't even think I was trying to become aware of it until after. Like, I was trying to adjust instead of hold it.
Yeah.
Just when you start feeling like you're about to then improve.
That's good. That means you're actually learning. All right. Let's change the subject, all right? Unless you have any last questions on that. Last question. All right. What else do you want to work on? Simple. Let's do the pock punch again. Pock punch. And then you just hold your guard, get the timing down, pock punch. Okay? Don't block. Just see if you can get the timing down first, same time.
Who's going
first? You? Yeah, do 10, 20, then whatever.
Feel active, like I'm kind of trying to put on more emphasis on the punch, and then I can also feel myself leaning in at that point.
Yeah, because when you do the drill, you do it the basic drill, okay? Let's say I'm trying to do pock punch to the individual. And then the way people look at it, it doesn't matter. The way people look at it is the main emphasis is what? Get the attack through, right? But the way I look at it when I do the drill is to maintain the zero point of my triangle. So when I go here, I want to make sure I'm at the zero point. If I go like this, see my little extension? If I extend out too much like this, I won't be at the zero point. Hard for me to actually apply it. But if I stay at my zero point of the technique and I move in, this is nice and smooth. I stay zero. See, I'm not even too concerned about the attack. I want to stay at the zero point each time. Right? See? Zero point. And I'm looking for the balance of the two hands, not simply just doing the punch. Mm-hmm. That's what people look at, just the punch. I look at the balance of the triangle overall. It's okay.